Welcome to Praise Church South Africa. We are glad that you chose to join us this morning. We are a church that believes in strengthening families for life.
Who's doing little or who's doing nothing? or you perceive they bring up, and it's this whole argument on social media, you know, because we've got time on our hands now, we can see all these things happening on social media. And you know what? It's like we each getting offended by each other. And do you understand that that weakens the kingdom of God? You understand that that weakens our strength and our authority and our power as children of God? And Jesus is saying, blessed is he who is not offended because of me. Can somebody say amen? Do not be offended by one another. Let's do the work of God. Amen. Let's do the work of the ministry. As they departed, Jesus began to say to the multitudes concerning John. Yes, Jesus talking to the people about John the Baptist is in prison. Who did you go out into the wilderness? Sorry, what did you go out into the wilderness to see? A reed shaken by the wind. But what did you go out to see? A man clothed in soft garments. Indeed, those who wear soft clothes are in king's houses. Because John the Baptist was this ruddy guy. They said he wore animal skins. And he ate locusts and honey for breakfast. He was a rough guy, long hair. And so he didn't look the part of as a prophet, you know. And he says, but what did you go out to see? A prophet? Yes, I say to you. And more than a prophet. Jesus is praising John the Baptist. For this is he who is written, whom it is written. Behold, I send my messenger before your face, who will prepare your way before you. Assuredly, I say to you, among those born of women, there has not risen one greater than John the Baptist, but he who is the least in the kingdom of heaven is greater than he. Isn't that so powerful? Amen. Even John was so great, but he that is the least is greater than him. Come on, say amen. And verse 12 is my theme verse today. And from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffers violence, and the violent taking it by force. From the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffers violence, and the violent taking it by force. Come on, somebody. From that day to now, the kingdom of heaven is suffering violence, and the violence is taking it by force. What did Jesus mean when he said that? John the Baptist was a forerunner of Jesus. He was the prophet that declared a bold message saying, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. He was declaring the Messiah was coming. And yet he was doubting that he was the one because he was in prison. He had followers. He had baptized many people. But the kingdom was not suffering violence. So what is Jesus referring to? What is Jesus referring to? Listen to it in the NIV. From the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven has been forcefully advancing, and forceful men laid hold of it. There was a moving forward of the kingdom message in that time. And John the Baptist was the forerunner, saying, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. You know what it means to repent? Doesn't mean to be forgiven. It means to turn away from what you're doing. To turn from your wickedness. If you were going in this direction, you turn and go the other direction. Repent means to turn away. And that was the powerful message that John was proclaiming. John started a movement of the gospel. What Jesus was saying and describing, that this message of the kingdom was being declared by John the Baptist by forceful men. And this message was advancing. And this message was taking hold of the kingdom. And it was moving forward with authority. He was saying, the kingdom is available to us, to Caesar, from the days of John the Baptist to now. The kingdom of heaven is advancing. God's kingdom is moving forward. And forceful men and forceful women will seize it and take a hold of it and will run with it and declare the word, repent, This is to be amplified. And from the days of John the Baptist until the present time, the kingdom of heaven has endured violent assault, and violent men seize it by force. What Jesus is saying, we have to take a hold of the kingdom. Can somebody say amen? You have to take a hold of it by force. Hallelujah. The kingdom is our salvation. The kingdom is the Holy Spirit. The kingdom is our place in heaven, our spiritual inheritance. I want to read one more translation in the Passion Translation. Verse 12 says, from the moment John stepped onto the sea until now, the realm of heaven's kingdom is bursting forth, and passionate people have taken hold of its power. For all the prophets and the Torah prophesied until John appeared. I want to ask you the question, Church of the Living God, are you those passionate people? Are you that forceful church? I say to my wife, you know, the moment the church closes up, to start up church again, it's a mission. It's a big thing, because people go into a habitual state. They get lazy, they get tired of coming to church. They use the coronavirus and all of that to say, I don't need to go to church. I can watch it online. And so there's a state of lax. There's a state of laziness and complacency. And we as men of God are afraid to offend people. We are afraid to rub you up the wrong way, for lack of a better word, church. We are afraid. But yes, Jesus said, from the time of John the Baptist till now, the kingdom of heaven suffers violence, and the violent take it by force. God is saying, I'm looking for people that will passionately pursue the kingdom and seize it. Hallelujah. I'm looking for people that don't care what people say and the opinions of others and what's going on around them and what is happening in our world. But they know this kingdom is higher than any other kingdom. It's the kingdom of the Most High God. And they will not let anyone stop them from preaching the kingdom.
Amen.
Oh, can somebody say amen? Are you forceful enough? Oh, hallelujah. Why are you trying to get through this thing? Is COVID, listen, beloved, COVID is a present day reality. The violent protests we saw is a present day reality of war. But the kingdom of heaven is suffering violence, and the violent taking it by force. It's only say amen. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. It's like this. If God had to put everything he had before you, all the delicacies, all the lovely food that you can think of, he had to lay it before you, and you go and sit at the table and just look at it. That's what it's like. The kingdom of heaven is here, but are you and I advancing this kingdom? Are you forcefully advancing this kingdom? I thought about it when the scripture came to me because of my wife. When this looting was going on, when this protest was going on, there were violent, he said to me, that scripture that says, the kingdom of heaven suffering violence and the violent taken by force. That's what it is. The people just felt and right. They felt there's something rose within them, that they felt an entitlement. They felt they didn't have to ask anybody. They walked past the police. They walked past everybody, even the owners of the businesses. And they took what they wanted. They just seized it. Their violence is taken it by force. That's what you and I ought to be doing in the kingdom. We ought to be violently pursuing the things of God. We ought to be forcefully pursuing. But we have this passive mentality. We are apologizing to everyone. We have to watch, you know, this hate speech and as well that I've got to watch what I say on social media. I've got to watch what I say to the people. I'm saying to you today, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Turn around and forcefully advance the kingdom. Church, rise up. Where is the church of Jesus Christ? I'm asking you today, where is the church of Jesus Christ? If Jesus doesn't come, will he find you? Will he even choose you? Or will you just be hiding in a corner somewhere, pretending that you're a child of God, pretending that you're a Christian? I'm saying to you today, It's time for the church. The kingdom of heaven is here and available. And you and I have to have the energy and the power to take over. Can somebody say amen? I'll say to you today, I am making no apology for serving God. This last breath that I have in my body, because I feel like I tasted death. I feel like I tasted death. And this last breath that I have in my body, I'm going to proclaim the word of the kingdom. Can somebody say amen? You know, there's two meanings of the word receive in the Bible. There's two meanings. Let me share this with you quickly. The one is the passive receiving, where you don't have to do anything. It's just handed to you. And then there's another translation where you can see this is my iPad. And you just come and take it from me. There's that. You just come and take it. Come, just take this from me. You got it? Amen. Just take it. Just put it on my hand. That's kind of receiving. You understand? Now, that's the receiving that God is talking about when he says the scripture, this is John 1:12. But for as many as received him, to them give him the power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. For as many as received him. What receive is that? Exactly what Jacob did now. They took him. They pursued him. You understand? They seized him. That's what God is talking about us. We are to pursue him. He's not going to pursue us. We are to pursue him. We are to pursue the kingdom. That's what Jesus was saying to John the Baptist. The kingdom of heaven is suffering violence. That message that even you proclaim, John, is pursuing. He's taking it by force. You and I have to seize him. We have to take him. Can somebody say amen? And I'm saying to you today, are you that passionate person? I've seen so many people fall by the wayside in this season of pandemic. They thought in the last 1 month, 21 days, or whatever it was. We thought in the last 1 year, it's going to be 2 years just now. 2 years that we've had this life. And now it's going to be longer than that. So you have to learn to pursue the kingdom with this coronavirus. With the vaccine and with the mask. I said to my wife, we went for the vaccine this week and I got so sick. I thought that I had COVID again. And she was fine. But both of us had our arms were sore. But I thought to myself, look at the things we have to do now. We have to take a vaccine so that we have some chance of survival. But that's what it is, beloved. You know, you can't sit in a corner quietly and think everything is going to work out the way you want it. You have to pursue God. You have to run after him. The kingdom of heaven suffered violence, but the violent taking it by force. Can somebody say amen? Come on, say amen. Let me tell you about this kingdom. There is no kingdom like this kingdom. Hallelujah. The kingdom of heaven is greater than any other kingdom. Can somebody say amen? And rules over all realms. This kingdom has the greatest warriors. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit are our great warriors. And don't you think that God, the Father, cannot fight? He invented fighting, and he's fighting for you. He's fighting for me. The kingdom of heaven is greater than any other kingdom. Can somebody say, our God is strong and mighty? Come on, say, our God is strong and mighty. The kingdom of heaven is going to be victorious. Can somebody say amen? Excuse me. The kingdom of heaven is going to be victorious over all things. You just wait and see. The kingdom of heaven is going to be victorious. We are going to be victorious. Children of the living God, we are going to be victorious. This message is going to be preached. Everybody is going to hear about this gospel. Can somebody say amen? Everybody's going to hear. Don't allow resistance to stop you. Don't allow this world to stop you. Don't allow anything that's surrounding you to stop you. Can somebody say amen? It's time to get more aggressive, more determined. We have to be on the offense, not on the defense. You know, I don't condone lawlessness, because we as children of God should not be evil. We shouldn't behave with lawlessness. But I want you to know something. There are so many people, propagating, opening the church, even against the government's regulations. Why? Because the church is tired of being passive, apologizing. Every time there's a restriction, we close our doors. Everybody goes to their homes, but they do everything else. They even looted in the street and broke everything down with no mask and all of that on. And so there's lawlessness is abounding, and evil is abounding, and light is being snuffed. The light of the church is being snuffed. You need the church. Oh, come on. You need to be in the presence of God. You need to be amongst the believers, because faith will rise. Hope will rise. Come on, somebody. This message, I want you to know that what you're listening today and the atmosphere in this building, even though it's just a few of us, is charged with the power of God. I can sense Him in this place. And I'm saying to you today, that's why the church exists. That's why we have to be determined. Can somebody say amen? The gates of hell cannot prevail against us. Can somebody say amen? And we not to be offended. We need to stand by the word and advance the kingdom of God. Can somebody say amen? Can somebody say amen? I want you to know, we cannot adapt to the world. The church has lost its ground. And we need to advance the kingdom with force. We need to rise up and take our position as the church of Jesus Christ. Don't you know that rape has increased? Because children at home, child rape, there's molestation, and there's gender-based violence, there's all kinds of things, there's suicide. All of these things have increased because of the lockdown, because people are trying to run away from the virus. I'm saying to you, the kingdom of heaven needs to advance. We need to be the light in the world and be pursuing our communities to draw them to God. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Can someone say amen? Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Hallelujah. And you're a big amen today. Come on, somebody. And I'm saying to you today, we need revival. I want to end with this. There's a difference between rioting and protest. And I'm speaking about it in the context of what we've all experienced in the past 2 weeks ago with the unrest in our country, in South Africa. Many of us saw it. Many of us experienced it. Many of you saw it on TV. And I want to bring it into the context of the kingdom of heaven, suffering violence. Protest is a peaceful demonstration because it expresses what's in your mind verbally, peacefully. A riot expresses what's in your mind physically. It's an active protest. Riot, okay? There's damage of property. There's looting. People take things and carry away things and all of that. Listen to the dictionary. Riot is a disturbance of the peace created by an assembly of three or more people acting with a common purpose. That's what happened. There were three or more people acting with a common purpose. Because there were so many acting with a common purpose, nobody could stop them. Not an army, not the police, not the president himself. The president, if you could stand in front of them, in front of the lighting, he would have been mowed down. You understand? Why? Because they had a common purpose. Acting in violence to the terror of the people. Rioting is a disturbance of the peace by three or more people with one common purpose. We need a riot in the kingdom of heaven. Amen. Oh, hallelujah. We need a riot. I remember Carmen said, riot is a righteous invasion of truth. Righteous invasion of truth. We need a riot for three or more people to come together. Like the Bible says, where two or three are gathered in my name, I'm in the midst of you. Hallelujah. We need us to come together and with one common purpose, storm the gates of hell, destroy the kingdom of this world, because the kingdom of heaven must come down to the kingdom of this world, because there's no other kingdom like the kingdom of heaven. Let the violent take it by force. Hallelujah. Let's pursue the kingdom. Hallelujah. That's what you and I ought to be doing. Coming together but be so fragmented. Jesus prayed to the Father when he was about to be taken away. He said, I pray, Lord, make them one as we are one. May we be one, the church be one. If we come together, why are we all doing things in little fractions? Each guy must do his own thing to make his name great. Why can't we do it together? Why can't we put our efforts together like we saw? People came from everywhere, came with their pajamas on, with their gowns. They all just came together with one common purpose. And what took people? Somebody was telling me, Roger, you made it. Somebody told me what a DeFi was putting some things in their storeroom or something, and would have taken them, they projected it would have taken them a week to set up all this stock. What would have taken those people a week, the people that own the business, DeFi, whatever it is, took the looters one day to clean out. I remember watching it on TV, and the helicopter was flying over this looting, and the news reporter was saying, I said to my wife, if you're watching the news at home, and the news reporter is saying, it looks like these guys have supernatural strength. They were carrying heavy things on their back and they were moving it. Imagine what would happen to the kingdom of God if you and I come together. Oh, come on, somebody. If you and I just get united in one purpose and let's riot and plunder the devil's territory. Come on, somebody. Let's plunder heaven. Hallelujah. Plunder hell and populate heaven. Hallelujah. Can somebody say amen? I'm saying to you today, it's time for us to advance. Can somebody say amen? It's time that the kingdom of heaven, as it is in heaven, so shall it be in heaven. Your kingdom come, your will be done. As it is in heaven, so shall it be on earth. Come, let's stand together. Let's bow our heads together in prayer. Oh, from the time of John the Baptist till now, the kingdom of heaven suffers violence, and the violent taking it by force. I'm declaring to you today, you and I have to be that violent people, that passionate people, invading and pursuing forcefully the things of God. You got to put your muscle into it. I'm saying to you today, more than ever, I grew up in church. I grew up in church. I'm a pastor's kid. My grandfather was a pastor. I grew up in ministry. Never in my life did I see what's happening around us today. I'm saying to you, are you going to pull back? You're going to say, no, it's not for me, it's for pastor, it's for those people. And you're going to be a part of this world, get involved in all of this. You can't fight like them. We can't go and take guns and all of those things. That's not our part. Our part is to be the kingdom of heaven, advancing on the kingdom of this world. The children of God need to be forcefully advancing. That means you and I need to come together. You and I, I'm saying to you, the church must come together. Some way or the other, the church has to gather itself. The church has to be reaching out to the community. The church has to be saying, Pastor, we need help here. We need to do this, we need to do that. But what's happening is everybody's in their homes. Pastor's trying to figure out who needs food, what needs to be done, whatever, I care what happens this week, whatever. But everybody's in their homes, doing their own thing, carrying on their own life. Where is the forceful kingdom of heaven? Hallelujah. I'm saying to you today, let's come together. And I don't know, but the Lord put this on my heart. I know it's a strong word, but I'm saying to you, it's time to stop apologizing and start saying, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Repent. I'm saying to you, if there's ever a time you can get your life right with God, it's now. Stop messing it up. Stop doing those things. Get it right now. You don't know what's tomorrow. You don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. Amen. Now, I want to touch you right now. I want to pray for you. And then we're going to close the business of our hearts to the Lord right now. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Thank you
Thank you for joining us at Praise Church South Africa, Church Online. It was a joy to have you. If you were blessed, please feel free to like our broadcast, post a comment, and please do share this broadcast. You can connect with us on Facebook and YouTube at Praise Church SA, or visit our website at www.praisechurch.co.za. Alternatively, drop us an email at info@praisechurch.co.za. To give to God, our banking details will appear on the screen, and you can also snap scan for your convenience. Thank you again for being a part of our church service here at Praise Church South Africa, where our mission is reaching the world through the love and grace of Jesus Christ, cultivating true worshippers, and strengthening families for life. God bless you, family. See you next Sunday at 9:30 a.m.